Hello, my name is Kristen. Brown, I'm from the University of Queensland, just like everyone else. Here's just a slide of what we were doing underwater. That's Pierre and I. So I came to the Maldives to study the effect of human population on the competition dynamics between corals and algae. So I studied coral-algal interactions on the reef. And by interactions, I mean direct interactions, so where algae and coral directly touch. There's a few examples of the interactions that we've been seeing in the Maldives, just on the sides here. This is a crustaceous coral and algae competing with a crocodile. We have some poslopera and chlorodesmus here. This is a branching varieties with some articulate calcareous algae growing in between the branches. Another algae here, another crustaceous coralline, that's an erect crustaceous coralline, so a nice, beautiful algae, one of my favorites. Competing with another poslopera here, we have some halimeda here, which is an articulate calcareous as well. And by calcareous, I mean they're like corals in that they calcify. So, and then we have a calerpa overgrowing a fabia there. So I'm interested in what the impact of the increasing and intensifying human stresses have on coral reefs. So Maldives is a great place. This is a survey design that we had in visiting the unpopulated and the populated islands. It's good at looking at what the effects are local and globally. So we just got off the boat, so haven't really analyzed a lot of the data yet, but just have a few numbers here. We spent 2,418 minutes underwater. Delma and I did, which is over 40 hours, which is a long time. I detailed 2,420 different macro algae coral interactions. We saw 42 genera of coral interacting with 30 different genera of algae, and two were noticeably absent of the corals. We didn't see any Skywalpera or Ceratophora our entire trip, which is really shocking, actually. We were just in Chagos, which is just south of here, on the same ridge, and we did see both of those corals there, but we didn't see any while we were here after, 37 dives and surveying a section of reef. So that might be some sort of local extinction, I don't know, but yeah, very interesting. Dom took 3,150 quadrats at the bottom, so these are in addition to the images that we got from the camera, which I think was over 30,000 images. So we analyzed 2,000 of those on the cruise, which Jen will be presenting some of that data a little bit later. The average number of interactions between populated and unpopulated, so we have the populated atolls had about 68 interactions, and this is on a 30-meter transect, and the unpopulated had about 80, which is kind of interesting, I would say. Some people might think that on reefs that are populated, you might expect to find more algae and therefore more coral-algal interactions. However, we were seeing at the unpopulated sites where there may not have been a fair bit more coral, there's more competition and more coral-algal interactions. It became one of my hobbies looking for honeycomb eels on these dives, and I never saw one. But everyone else on my team did. So I saw a fair few eels, I estimate about 102, and no honeycomb eels. Anyways, that wraps it up.